Well, good morning, guys, and this is, and today we are doing Genesis 2. So, in Genesis 2, verse 7, I'm reading from the Living Bible, the 1943 version. Okay, this is 1971. So this game was printed 2 years after I was born. So yesterday we did Genesis 1, and God created heaven and earth, and he made man, and he made man and woman one being. Now my question is this: why did he make man and woman one being? One spiritual being. One spiritual being. So, I woke up at 3 o'clock this morning, okay, with this question. Question is, why did God make man and woman, spiritual being, one? Then, in Genesis 2, verse 7, the time came when God made that when the Lord God formed a man's body from the dust of the ground and breathed into him the breath of life, and man became a living person. Okay, so now there's one body, two people, two spirits. Now, God is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. He's three in one. Okay? Jesus is God and God is Jesus. Jesus is Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit is Jesus. And they both are God. Did he do it on purpose? For the sake of intimacy? Or well, seeing, I mean, God made everything from the start two, but man he made one first, but there were two. And then if you go to Genesis 2 from verse 18. And then the Lord God said, "It isn't good for man to be alone. I will make a companion for him, a helper, suited to his needs." So the Lord God formed from the soil every kind of animal and bird, and brought them to man to see what he would call them, and whatever he called them, that was their name. But there was still no proper helper for the man. Then the Lord God caused the man to fall into deep sleep, and took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh from which he had removed it, and made the rib into a woman and brought it to the man. "This is it," Adam exclaimed. "She is part of my own bone and flesh. Her name is woman, because she was taken out of man." This explains why man leaves his father and mother and is joined to his wife in such a way that when the two become one person, so God made them one person, two, spirit, huh? now God created one body. It was two people. Now there are two separate people. But now to me, it even says in the word, we'll get to it. A woman's desire is after her man, after her husband, after her husband. Let's get this right from the start. Her husband, not her man, because you can date, but he's not your husband. Her husband, not her man. And that is what intimacy is. God made them intimate from the start, from day one. They were one person, they were intimate, one. God is intimate in three, but we are intimate in one. I don't want to drag this on too long, so I'm going to do this in segments. They made them two bodies, but if they get together, they are one. They are one in spirit, not one in flesh. That is intimate with one another. To be intimate with one another. Now, it says, the next verse, the last verse, verse 25 says, now, although the man and the wife were both naked, neither of them was embarrassed or ashamed. Now to be with somebody that you love, that's your husband, that's your wife, you have to be naked. You have to totally remove everything and anything that can be a hindrance to getting to know that person inside and out. That is knowing their hopes, their fears, their dreams. Everything that is inside of them. And that is how God wants to know us. We need to be naked before Him. Can you do it? Can you really be naked before your Creator? Can you be naked with yourself?